Okay, for the past weeks, we have been talking about types of fools. Four types of fools.
Well, thank you so much.
What are those types of fools that we've been learning about? Can you guys help me out here? Yeah, when you make fun of people. The mocker. Awesome job, the mocker. Anyone else here to help me out? What are the other types of fools that we've been learning about this past month? The bullies, okay. The devil is a fool. You? Wickedness? Okay, two more. Let's see here. What about you? Yeah, one more. You. Exactly. Awesome job, guys. Okay, we're just gonna go through the four types of fools that we've been learning about. Okay, who here knows has learned about the mocker? Do you guys remember the mocker? How about the rebel? Do you guys remember the rebel? The simple? We've been learning about the simple, the rebel, the mocker, and the godless. Now, what do all these fools have in common? They, shout it out, what do you think they're evil, they're fools. Like, what are these types of fools? Like, what do they have in common? What do these good types of people always do? Yep, they're foolish. What they don't do is they don't trust in God. The mocker, the rebel, the person who goes against God, the simple, those who don't give thought to their actions, the godless, those who don't even believe in God, they all don't trust in God. You see, foolishness is not trusting in God. It's like you're king. You are king of your own life. It's kind of like, I am king of this land. No one's gonna boss me. You can't tell me what to do. You can't tell me what to do. Mr. Tim can't tell me what to do. Miss Tracy can't tell me what to do. I am my own man. God can't tell me what to do. I don't trust anyone except myself. I am the king. Exactly. If I was king over my own life, if I chose to do whatever I wanted to, I'd be foolish. If I didn't trust in God, I'd be foolish. Hey, can you pull up the memory verse for today? It's Proverbs 1.
No waywardness.
Of the simple.
We'll kill them.
Will kill them, and the laziness of fools will destroy them. So basically, foolishness is not trusting in God. And when we're foolish, it will destroy us. It will kill us. You see, there's a story in the Bible. It's about Abram and Lot. Who here knows of Abram and Lot? Who here knows of Abraham? You see, Abraham was called Abram before God changed his name. You see, Abram. Abram lived in this nice little town. You know, he was pretty comfortable where he was. But one day, God called to him and said,
Abram.
He's like, whoa, is that God? Hey God, what's up? What's up?
He's like, you must move to the land that I have chosen for you. If you trust me, I will make you prosperous.
He's like, I don't know, I've got a pretty comfortable here, but Lord, Abram goes, hey, I trust you, Lord. I trust you.
I will take care of you, Abram. Now go.
He's like, okay, I'll go. Abram took everything he had. All his sheep, all his cattle, took everything with him. And his nephew, Lot, went with him too. Now, I need someone to help me here. Anyone come up here? Let me see. You come on up. Let's see what we got here. Come on up, Jonah. Let's go. We should have talked about Jonah today. Anyway. Okay, so come back here. Come back here. Okay, this is the starting point. This is where Abram and Lot used to live. And now we're going to the land God has promised us. Okay, you are Abram, okay? And I'm Lot, okay? Now let's walk. Now let's travel. We're walking down the road. We're walking. Oh yeah. I'm walking. I'm jogging. Just walk down 2, 3, 4, 10. Come on. Don't be shy. Come on. Stop. You can't go straight anymore. You can't go straight. I mean, our Abram and Lot's families have been growing and growing. They're getting too big. They can't. If they stay together long enough, they won't have enough food to eat. So they gotta split up now. So, Abram, that's you. Let's Lot, that's me, decide which path to choose. Foolishness or wisdom? Which one do you think I should choose? Lot should have chosen wisdom, but he didn't. He was king over his own life. He was like, I can do whatever I want. No one can stop me. So, no. No one can tell me what to do. And so he went down the path of foolishness. He's like, oh, look at this. Look at this. This whole suitcase full of goodies. So it's just like candy and stuff and Hannah Montana tickets. Yeah. So, and look at this. Compared to that, you can't fit in it. You can't fit that much stuff in here. But that suitcase, there's so much more stuff in there. So much more candy. Hannah Montana tickets. Possibly Jonas Brothers too. Okay, I'm going over there. Lot went to foolish way. He wanted those Hannah Montana tickets. So he was like, I can't. You stay over. Abram didn't go down a foolish way. Just stay there. I'll get to you later. Okay. Lot was really excited. Kind of like, oh, I can't wait for those Hannah Montana tickets. Yes. Oh, come on. Get up. Uh-oh. Lot chose the bad way. Because foolishness leads to death. You see, Lot chose to go down the path of foolishness. He went to this place called Sodom and Gomorrah, and it may have looked, oh, so awesome. It was actually not a good place to live. You see, those people over there were living bad lives, sinful lives, and God didn't like that. And Lot chose that place. Now later on, God spoke to Lot and said, I'm going to destroy this place. You better get out of there. And so Lot went. Lot got out of there. And God destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah. Lot lost everything, including his wife. Lot lost everything he had, all because he went down the path of foolishness. All because he was king over his own life. He didn't trust in God. Because he didn't trust in God, it led to death. However, Abram, on the other hand, that's you, chose to trust in God. He said, you know, I'm not going to be king over my own life. I'm going to trust in you, Lord. I'm going to trust in you. So let's go. Let's walk the path of wisdom. Let's go. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. So we got this little bag here. Got this little bag. So it doesn't really look that impressive, but if you look in here, there's something in here. Maybe you hold that up. What does this read? Exactly. When we follow the path of wisdom, we get life. You see, when Abram trusted in God, God blessed him immensely. God blessed him like 100 times over. You see, Abram chose to go to the land of Canaan, which was like not that impressive. It was kind of like a desert almost. But God told him that he was going to be very successful there. Because he trusted in God. Anyway, I think there's something else in there for you too. Pick that out. So, thank you, Jonah, for helping me. Give Jonah a big hand. So, when we walk a path of foolishness, when we're king over our own lives, when we start to trust in ourselves, start to trust in other people, start to trust anybody, but we don't trust in God, that's foolishness. That's foolishness. And that foolishness leads to death. But by trusting in God, we become wise. We say, God, I can't do this anymore. God, I can't live without you. I need to trust in you every single day of my life. That's wisdom. That's being smart. And when we trust in God, it gives us life. Now, there's one more verse that I want to touch on. It's Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. How many of you guys know Proverbs 3, 5, and 6? Well, this is from another version of the Bible called the Message Bible. Now, I want you guys to stand up. It's not up there. So I want you guys to stand up. We're going to repeat it. So, okay, repeat after me, guys. Okay? 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 Okay. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. Trust God. Figure out everything on your own. Listen for God's voice. Foolishness is not trusting in God. And when we're foolish, it doesn't lead to life. But when we're wise, we trust in God. And that leads to life. Everyone bow your heads, close your eyes. You see, Abram trusted in God, and in turn, God gave him so much more than he expected. You see, Jesus Christ died on the cross and rose again to forgive us of all of our sins. And all we need to do is trust in Jesus as our personal Lord and Savior. And we can have the best life ever. And we can get, and later we can get to, we will go to heaven. Now, if there's anyone who hasn't trusted Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior for the first time and wants to today, please raise your hand. Awesome. Sweet. Awesome. Everyone, put your hands down. Now, we're all gonna say this prayer together. We're gonna talk to God. Now, repeat after me. Dear God, thank you for sending Jesus to die on the cross for all my sins. And he rose again on the third day. God, I'm sorry for all the sins and mistakes I made. Please forgive me. Jesus, thank you for your forgiveness. Thank you that I am a new creature. And God, help me to trust in you in everything I do, everywhere I go. Thank you for loving me, Jesus. I love you. In Jesus' name, amen. Awesome, guys. Awesome. For those of you who made Jesus Christ your personal Lord and Savior for the first time, awesome. Best decision you will ever make. Now, if you got any questions about how to live a Christian life, or questions about the Bible, or if you need someone to talk to about prayer, you can talk to me. You can talk to any one of your teachers. That's what we're here for. We have open ears. You can tell us anything that's going on in your life. Okay? Okay. Now, who's gonna go back to the roots first? Now, the people who are not gonna be here first are the people that are quietest. The quietest people will go first. Who will it be? Third grade is up! Who's next? Let's see here. Who's next to me? Thank you.